The Transportation Department vows to strengthen its regulations after a bill that sought to create a Transportation Safety Board was vetoed. President Marcos has said he vetoed the measure as it would only duplicate existing functions of some offices. The DOTR agreed with the president's move. The safety board would have been authorized to conduct hearings, investigations, and special studies on major or fatal transportation accidents.
Ay meron ng mandato para sa safety regulation at ang naging direksyon ng ating veto statement mula sa ating Pangulo ay ang paigtingin at palakasin ang mandato sa safety regulation ng ating mga existing agencies instead na gumawa tayo ng bagong ahensya. So tayo syempre ay susuporta dyan sa direksyon na yan at susundin ang direksyon ng ating veto statement ng ating Pangulo ukol dito sa transportation safety.
A Philippine senator seeks an investigation into an alleged COVID vaccine wastage worth 5 to 13 billion pesos. Citing reports, Senator Riz-Ontiveros said it's possible there were 4 to 27 million unused and expired doses bound to be thrown away. She asserts the goal of the investigation is to determine what caused the alleged wastage so that it can be addressed. The Health Department welcomes any possible investigation.
Always be open naman ano para sa mga ganitong pag-iimbestiga para makapagpaliwanag po tayo ng maayos and having that right platform or avenue kung saan pwede tayong makapagbigay ng datos at maipaliwanag. So we will be explaining all of these things through our data and analytics kapag dating po ng pag-iimbestiga na yan. We do not have an oversupply. Pag tinignan ho natin ang mga estima, kaya tayo bumili niyan kasi binilan natin ang ating populasyon ng Pilipino. Nagkataon, pagdating ng mga bakuna dito, marami ang nagkaroon ng hesitancy. Marami rin po ang hindi pa pumupunta para makakuha ng kanilang scheduled na allocation for the vaccine. So it's not really oversupply. Kailangan lamang talaga maabot natin yung mga eligible population so that we can consume these vaccines.
Private hospitals see a slight increase in COVID-19 admissions. But Dr. Jose Rene de Grano, the president of Private Hospitals Association of the Philippines, says the situation is still manageable. He adds they are now preparing their isolation rooms following the detection of the Centaurus Omicron subvariant as well as the monkeypox virus in the country.
What we are doing right now is just the same, more or less, what we are doing during the COVID pandemic. No, we are preparing for our isolation areas because the what is important here is awareness, our detection, and of course isolation of these suspect cases.
The Philippines implements another border screening measure as a precaution against monkeypox. Incoming passengers of international flights will now be asked to roll up their sleeves as they enter the country's main gateway. This is on top of the thermal scanner, which monitors body temperature.
Alerto po yung mga doctors natin and nurses sa airport. May mga nakukuha po tayo na may mga skin lesion. And ito po ay dinadala kagad natin sa RITM at kagandahan naman po out of siguro mga less than 10 na nakuha natin may mga skin lesion, nag-negative naman po sila sa monkeypox po.
The Bureau of Quarantine admits the screening test for incoming passengers is not foolproof, but it can minimize the risk of more cases of monkeypox entering the country.